Approaching warily, he was reassured that Watchman V was friend, not foe. And the prince rewarded the regimental mascot with an enthusiastic pat on the head. Watchman V and his handler Greg Hedges undertake a number of remembrance events to support the Royal British Legion Poppy Appeal. A Staffordshire Bull Terrier, he continues his duties as part of the Staffordshire Regimental Association. Harry laughed and joked with veterans after laying a wooden cross at Westminster Abbey's Field of Remembrance ahead of Armistice Day. He even suggested that he might bring his girlfriend Meghan Markle to the event next year. Harry joked with Matt Weston, who was a bomb disposal expert in Afghanistan, about bringing his U.S. actress girlfriend to the event, around a year after their relationship hit the headlines. Mr. Weston, 28, said I took the mickey and asked where his missus was and he said she wasn't here. I asked if she would come next time because she's awesome, and he said he couldn't hide her anywhere, but I said you wouldn't have to hide her. I would love to meet her, I think she's very cool. He's a very lucky man and she's brilliant. Mr. Weston, from Taunton, Somerset, lost both his legs when an improvised explosive device exploded in 2009 while he was serving with the Royal Engineers 33 Regiment. He said it was great seeing him again. I met him before at the Afghanistan and Iraq Memorial unveiling. Harry also stopped to talk to 7-year-old Harrison DeGiorgio Lewis, who he recognized after meeting him at the Abbey last year. Harrison's uncle, Lieutenant Aaron Lewis, of 29 Commando Regiment Royal Artillery, was killed in Afghanistan in December 2008 when insurgents attacked a forward operation base he jointly commanded with Danish troops. Harrison, who was accompanied by his grandmother, Helen Lewis, was wearing his uncle's campaign medals and beret. He has been coming here for 4 years now to represent his uncle, said Mrs. Lewis, 61, who lives near her grandson in Rochford, Essex. She added Harry recognized him, they have a bond, as they share a birthday. Harry asked him about his uncle Aaron, and he said how proud he was. Harry, dressed in his household division frock coat and peaked cap, laid across in the grounds of Westminster Abbey when he arrived. He solemnly saluted and stood in silence with hundreds of veterans as the last post was played. Harry later stopped to talk to Joan Daval and Diana Lidstone, who served with the Auxiliary Territorial Service, the women's branch of the British Army, during the Second World War. Mrs. Lidstone, 93, from Luton, said he asked how we were and if we're staying down over the weekend. Mrs. Daval, 92, added that was wonderful to meet Harry on the 100-year anniversary of women serving in the British military. The prince shared a joke with D-Day veteran George Chandler, 93, who has been coming to the event for 15 years. Mr. Chandler, who served with the Royal Navy Coastal Forces, said last year he asked me what's in my bag and I said a bottle of water and a machine gun. This year I told him I'd bring them and he laughed at that. Around 70,000 tiny crosses, many carrying handwritten messages, are laid on 380 plots in the Abbey grounds representing military regiments, units, organizations and other groups. Harry served for 10 years in the Army, and was twice deployed to Afghanistan.